Hello, Hello, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to use two of the three features of Hyper's Outliner system, how to set up outliners on your Interactables, and how to attach symbols to them. I would do the scene depth, but I'm not really thinking about using the scene depth in my game. But if people ask me, I will try to add a video on that. I didn't really look into it, so I don't really fully understand it. But I think you need the world outliner in his outliners fold outliner system. This thing, I do believe you need that. But anyways, so. To start off, what you need is you need a copy of the advanced outliner. So duplicate, rename it to whatever you want. Me, I put my version in my PDS so it doesn't get overwritten or missing. Systems, Hyper, Outliner, see? And you attach that to your player. And then go to your Interactable master. All right. Now, in this video, we're gonna make a macro, a spawn outliner symbol, a pure function of is symbol attached, a pure function of get attached symbol actor, a destroyed attached symbol. Also get outliner. Get outliner type, and that's going to be an enum outliner type. Give symbol tag, give outliner tag. You don't need to do these; are optional, but they'll be explained later on in the video. And static mesh called get symbol mesh. All right, so. Cut these. First things first, we get the outliner component. Basically, it's from one of his examples in his demo video. Basically, it's well, that's not it, but it's similar to that. But anyways, this is scene depth. I was looking at scene depth earlier. But anyways, on the get back to the get outliner macro. Get player character, get component of class, and make sure you select AC Outliner Abstract. Outliner Abstract. All right, put the return value into the outputs. Name it Outliner. And I have it set in my categories Interactable. Now, then we go to is symbol, we create a pure function called is symbol attached. So functions, and then just check pure. Make sure you do interactable. All right. Since I already did it, I'm just going to show you. Is symbol attached, you get your outliner component macro. Pull off and do check if actor has symbol attached, and naturally the actor's gonna be self, and it's gonna go down to all the children. And then from the boolean symbol attached, you just put that in return node. Make sure you select pure if you want to keep your stuff nice and organized, but interactable. And the same thing's gonna be for you could probably just copy. Get its symbol attached and name it get attached symbol actor. This is the same thing, but in this case, we're just attaching the symbol actor attached to the return node. And naturally, it's still self get outliner opponent macro. Next, get rid of those. We're going to do spawn outliner symbol. Get outliner component, do server spawn replicated symbol. Spawn server spawn replicated symbol. Do the spawn transform. You can set the transform however you want. You could even just do it like that. Add a pinnode here. Alright, and what I'm going to do is for the z-axis for default, I'm going to put 200. Alright. I'm going to make little name symbol. Symbol mesh that we were talking about before. See those little variables we were talking about before? And a parent actor is naturally the cell. Okay. Put that out of the way. And it's a see? 200 naturally by default. And then destroy attach symbol. All this is get line or opponent, server destroy symbol by actor. And you remember that pure function gets attached symbol that we made earlier? That's all. Okay. Now, in the previous video, we went over and made a chest. So we're going to start with the chest. So in the construction script, I have the check, if you remember, give outliner tag. If it's true, we're going to check to see if we have the symbol tag. If that's true, we're going to get the chest box. See the box and lid. I have two static meshes here. And we're going to make an array. Oh, sorry. We're going to get set. We're going to drag off of here and do set component. There we go. Set component tags. And then drag off of here and do make array. Now you have to spell these exactly as it's out here because that's what he had to ask. All lowercase outline, all lowercase symbol. All right, just add pin to add a pin. If you actually made one, just right click, move array. But do it for the chest box and the chest lid. Now, if we don't have the symbol tag, we just need to give the outliner tag. We do the outline. We do it here. Now, if we don't have the outliner tag, but we are giving the symbol tag, put them here. All right. Another way you could do this is just by adding them here, I believe. I haven't tried that, but that's another way. Just go to select the blueprint itself, type in tag in the search panel here, and just add them there. But I'm not doing that. Okay, so we have that. Now for the outliner type here, I put third. All right. Let's go to your event graph. And on event begin play, you're going to check if both static messages have symbol tag. If that's true, we're going to check to see if a symbol is attached. If it's false, we're going to spawn the outliner symbol that we made in the master. So just type in spawn outliner symbol. Put it in there. If they don't have the symbol tags, and it's false, we're going to check if there's one attached anyways. If there is, it shouldn't be, but just in case there is, we're going to come out of true and do destroy attached symbol. Now, for the braziers, it's the same thing. So I go to my lighting master. Wait, actually, I'm jumping ahead. Now, what I'm going to do for the interactable to get rid of it is we did this in the last previous video. Here it is. So, is it open? So, if you remember, we reset the previous videos, we reset these do once macros. But if since it's already since they're closed, because I don't think a chest is going to be open, but if they're closed, what we're going to do is destroy attached symbol. And then we're going to reset. Alright. For the brazier. Same thing. Construction script. We have a sequence. Press S and click for sequence. This is from the previous video. And then we come down here and do the same thing. But since we only have one mesh, it's not showing up, but since we only have one mesh, we just, let me click these off here because they're annoying me. We just check, do we have an outliner tag? If it's true, symbol tag, if that's true, they're both true. We give the torch mesh the outline and symbol tags. If the symbol tag is false, we get the outline for the component tag of the torch. However, if the outliner tag is false and the symbol tag is true, you give it the symbol tag. All right. Then the event graph, if it begin play, we do a sequence. This time it's kind of reverse. First thing we do is we check for the tag. If it has a tag, we check if the symbol is attached. If it's false, we spawn one. If we're not supposed to have a tag, but we have a symbol attached, it destroys the attached symbol. And then we do the, is it, if it's on, then we play the audio. However, and then on if it interact, it should be off by default. Set visibility, play is on. So is symbol attached? If it's true, we destroy the attached symbol. Now, I did find, I didn't think about it at the time, but on the portal, I did, I just wanted to see if it was possible. So I had the same thing here. In the event graph, same thing. And I just added, it's symbol attached, destroy attached symbol. It will spawn a symbol for the algebra, but it won't show the outliner, mainly because there's no mesh. I didn't think that was going to happen, but just out of curiosity, I wanted to try. So if you got all those, then you come out here, add them in there, and in your interactable tab for the portal, you can see this one shows it cannot interact. It has no outliner tag, no symbol mesh. Here, the symbol mesh is in hyper, resource pack, prop, symbols, mesh. I'm using the symbol arrow down for this one. This one here has an outliner tag. This one here has outliner tag and symbol with exclamation point symbol mesh. For here, where's your outliner tag off? This one has a symbol tag for a question mark. This one has no symbol tag but has an outliner. So these are great for like if you have a quest, you want to add a symbol tag to something. Maybe you want to mark certain lights that need to be turned on to open up a portal. That kind of thing. It's pretty cool. So, like I said, when you come in here, as you can see the little nice little blue outliner. And you see the symbol goes bye-bye. I got a nice little symbol tag here. back to Brazier, and Shovel Tag is off. Doesn't come on. Still can't interact with that one. I don't know why that does that. It's like they, when the camera is out of the radius, I need to find a way to get it when the player is out of the radius, not the camera. And as you can see here, the symbol tag is right there. And it shuts it off. So yeah, I hope this was helpful for you. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions or if you would like me to try to do this in depth, just let me know. Have a good day.